So we're by a lake, wearing life vests, and we're going to look at waves. To start with, just throwing a rock in and looking at the pattern. So what are the shapes? How many do you see? And what happens to them as they come closer to you? We're going to do it again, and this time let's look at the effect of the small ripples on the leaf that you can just see at the bottom of the screen. And again, still at the lake, just looking at putting two rocks in simultaneously, and then looking at the patterns that are formed when the ripples overlap. Let's do it in the lab with the wave table. You can see the red buttons that are vibrating. There's a light above, and actually, what we're looking at are the shadows of the waves underneath, and you get a really clear image of those interference patterns. Lighter, obviously, where more light travels through, and then the dark regions where light isn't passing through. The water's actually thicker at those parts where the ray waves from both of the vibrating spheres reinforce each other, and so you get those dark patterns emanating out from where they're formed. And then we're looking at a different frequency, the overall same pattern, where you get the darker areas and then the lighter areas where the
And if you
waves
change
cancel
the
each other out as they meet. And
you can change the frequency.
just
Yeah. Yeah.
very
Change the
slightly
pattern. I'll
changing the
try it.
frequency. But the
We'll get a
interference
little closer
patterns,
together.
the overall pattern, will remain the same. You can make interference patterns with single barriers that move backwards and forwards, and we'll look at that in a later video.
That's really good. It's not bad, is it?
And with thanks to physics teacher Tony Godwin for setting up and helping with this particular video. Thanks, Tony.